Worship the Lord, اعبد ربك حتى يأتيك اليقين. Until اليقين or certainty, which refers to death, comes to you. To the end of your life. كل موضع من مواضع حياتنا أيها الأحباب هو موضع عبادة. Each single second in our life, a moment in our life is a place of worship, is a box to fill with either good or bad deeds, hopefully inshallah with good deeds. Ibadat, we always say, doesn't refer only to salah and siyam and fasting and the like, but each single second of your life, it is time to have fun with your family and wife and kids and spouse. This is the ibadah of this time. It is time to work and make money and support yourself. This is the ibadah of that specific time. It is time to play with your kids and give them the time. This is the ibadah of that specific time. And so on. فَأَعْطِ كُلَّ ذِي حَقٍ حَقٍ. You have a lot of people and a lot of things that have rights on you. Give each one their due rights, the rights that are due to them. لِبَدَنِكَ. Your body has rights over you. Your spouse has rights over you. And so forth. So let's debalance and give Ramadan a little bit, you know, higher, going up as far as the ibadat al-ruhaniyat, the spirituality, getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't mean this is the end of it. But other times we have other ibadat to you. Bottom line is, كما قال سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام, he talked in the cradle, Maryam alayhi salam coming with this beautiful baby to her people, and everybody accused her. And we know, Isa alayhi salam, Prophet Isa, he talked in the cradle. And amongst what he said, قال, وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ مَا دُمْتُ حَيَّا. He said, I am Abdullah, I am the servant of Allah. And then he said, Allah give me this and that. And he advised me or ordered me to do salat and zakat, to pray to him and to give zakat as long as I'm alive. Do ibadah or ma dumtu hayya, as long as I am alive. So many forms of ibadah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to in the Quran, that we might neglect. الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ. Those who remember and mention Allah. One of the highest forms of ibadah is to be keen about Him. Is to have Allah in your memory, in your mind, in your thoughts. Think of Him, mention Him, dhikrullah. When? Qiyaman, standing. Wa qu'udan, sitting. Wa ala jubuhihim, even when they are on their sides, like laying down to get asleep or something. Always thinking of Allah. Wa yatafakkaroon, and they are reflecting and thinking and pondering over what? خلق السماوات والأرض. وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. They always think of the creation of the السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, the skies and earth. Think and look around and reflect and go deeper into things. رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ. They always say, oh our Lord, you have not created all of that in vain, for no purpose, سُبْحَانَكَ. Glorified are you above all of that. So that is another form of ibadah. And now the question. The main goal of fasting was obviously not to lose weight, even though it's good and one of the subservient goals, amongst the many subservient goals that we might get, or benefits or gains. But the ultimate goal of fasting was لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, that you may gain a taqwa. Did we get a taqwa? نَسْأَلُ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلَنَا مُتَّقِينَ. Ramadan is gone, we fasted, we prayed. Really, we need to check. Because Allah said, Ramadan, first ayah, He said, it has been prescribed for you. It is prescribed to you, as it has been prescribed for those before you, so that you gain taqwa. You become conscious of Allah. You become more obedient to Allah. Al-amal bita'ati Allah ala rulin min Allah. To always do the actions of obedience to Allah, following the light, the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way He likes. So do we gain that? Do we feel more, you know, towards al-ta'a and it becomes more easy on us? That's what we're supposed to have gained by now, and inshallah we have gained it. If we gain a taqwa, if we become more muttaqoon, more filtering of what we see and what we hear and what we speak and what we do, which is a taqwa, you pay attention. Am I supposed to have this look or hear that or be involved in that conversation or take that transaction or do that, or if you are conscious and ask yourself questions before you do any of these things, then you have achieved a higher level of a taqwa. As if you are walking in a path of thorns and harmful items, and you will be so much careful as far as your clothes and your feet not to get hurt. That is a taqwa. We are going in a hayah, in a life, in a dunya that is full of a lot of attractions here and there. All of these attractions are meant to take us away from Allah. So we have to be keen, so much conscious, to stay straight, going straight, and filter anything whether it pleases Allah or not. If we do that, Allah said, "Inna karamakum 'inda Allahi atqakum," the most noble of you, the most honorable of you in the sight of Allah are those who are highest in taqwa. Ramadan is there to teach you to be higher in the level of taqwa, and when you get higher in the level of taqwa, being conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you become the closest to Him, the most noble to Him, the most honorable to Him. Allahumma akram an-nasi 'alayka rabbil 'alamin. And now, one of the benefits also of gaining a taqwa according to the Quran that we have recited the Fadlillah Azza wa Jalla in the Taraweeh, and we heard and we recited elsewhere from the Masahib, Allah said, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever got a taqwa of Allah, be conscious of Allah, fears Allah, Allah will always give him a makhraj, an exit, and a way out. Any problem, any trouble, you will see a way out. قَدْ نَعْبَسَ كُلَّ مُطَبَقَةِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ لَجَعَلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ بَيْنِهَا مَخَرِجَ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Abdullah ibn Abbas said, if the sky, if the heavens of the sky will fall down on earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide al-mutaqoon, those who are conscious of Him, who have taqwa for Him, He will give them a way out somehow, some niches to go through. That's what He said in the Quran. Whoever fears Allah and whoever has taqwa to Allah, Allah will always give him a way out. وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And He will always provide him from sources that he did not even expect. He give you risk from whatever you did not expect. This was the first question. Did we gain a taqwa? We need to, inshallah, answer this question and keep. If the answer is yes, and hopefully it is, inshallah, azza wa jal, we need to keep. How can we keep? The second question, هل قبل الصيام؟ هل قبل الصيام؟ Is our fasting accepted? Because it's not things that we do and we throw away. You do not collect gold and silver and diamonds and just throw them away. I got them. Yes, you got them. They are yours. But you have to keep them in a safe place, in a bag or box or something. Not just collecting them and then putting them in the front yard or something, or in the mailbox, or you don't do that. So we have collected and we have done a lot to collect what we collected in Ramadan, inshallah, hasanat, عتق من النار, مغفرة, forgiveness, all of that. Let's keep that. Let's keep it in a safe place and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He accepts what we have done. Not just that we have done it and it should be accepted, we are much better than others and we should be accepted. No, it doesn't work this way. We have to always be, you know, in that verge, like, Ya Allah, did you accept from us or not? Please accept. And we always make dua for Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, like the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even though He was accepted and He was given forgiveness and issued, you know, forgiveness for everything, yet He's still very abdan shakur, very grateful kind of servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and always asking Allah to accept Him. Allahumma ja'alna min al-maqbuleen min al-taqeen. Allahumma ya. The third point is we have to really at this point be so much thankful to Allah. We have to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because what we have achieved is a lot. Some of us probably could not fast because of, you know, being traveling or sick or not capable of fasting for any reason. And some has left us. Some people have already died before Ramadan. They did not get the chance to catch Ramadan. We go to Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, did all of these things in Ramadan. Now we have to be thankful to Allah. Allahumma laka alhamdu wa laka shukr ya rabbil alameen. We thank you to the utmost of the levels of shukr alhamdu ya rabbil alameen. So the hadith of Abu Hurairah are talking about two companions, two brothers, companions of the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, friends of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. One of them, he passed away as a shaheed, a martyr, which is one of the highest level. He sacrificed his life for the sake of Allah. And his brother passed away 1 year later after him. And he passed away just normal death. And Talha, one of the Sahaba, he said, I saw in a dream those two companions, and I saw the one who passed later, 1 year later, normally on his bed. I saw him getting to Jannah before his brother who passed away, Shaheed, Mata Shaheed. دخل الجنة قبل أخيه. How come? And he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, how in the world is that possible? Shaheed, we know that this is the highest level. It's just like prophets with the prophets and angels. As Allah said in the Quran, how come his brother, the one who just did not die as Shaheed, and he got to that level? He said, أَلَيْسَ قَدْ عَاشَ بَعْدَهُ كَمْ Didn't he live after him for such and such days or such and such period of time? Didn't he fast one extra Ramadan? Didn't he pray such and such extra salawat? So it makes a big difference, one Ramadan that you catch like that, it should make a huge difference. It should take you way above anybody else who did not, you know, get that chance. Laylatul Qadr, just remember the ayah, خَيْرُ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ Better than 1,000 months. Brother Dak was, if we always think of 82, 83 years. No, that's better than that. It could be 1,000 years. It could be 20,000. Because Allah said, He didn't say, Laylatul Qadr ka'alfi shahr. He didn't say it equals 1,000 months. No, it's better than khayrun minhu. So that should put this hadith in perspective for us. So, and one of the signs, or some of the signs for our actions, whether they are accepted or not, if you want to know their actions are accepted or not, as we all know, من أميز العلامات, one of the most notable signs is that how is your level of ta'a right now? Are you happy that Ramadan is gone and no more fasting and I'm done with that? Obviously, you know, in a sense that you don't want it, you're done. If it was so, you know, hard and sad for you and you don't want to do it again, obviously that's like, you're not going to be accepted like that. But if you miss Ramadan, if you do, try to do, even if you didn't do, but try to do good as you did in Ramadan. No, I'm not supposed to do that. I used to be at this level of Ramadan. Let me try to get close to it. Let me pray at night a little bit. Let me control my tongue a little bit as I used to do while fasting. Hasana ba'da hasana. You do good after you do good. After you do good in Ramadan, you like to do it again. That means you succeeded the course. You graduated the course. You are implementing the course that you learned in Ramadan. But if you do the opposite, get back to the reverse, get back to the worst, then most likely it's not accepted. One of the suggestions of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommended for us, من صام رمضان, whoever fasts the month of Ramadan, وَأَتْبَعَهُ سِتَّةً مِنْ شَوَّالٍ, and then you follow that, with fasting 6 days of Shawwal, they could be right after Eid, they could be at any later time during the month of Shawwal, 6 days of fasting, that means you did not like hate fasting, you are trying to get to continue it, because yes, not the entire month and not as much as you can, maybe one or two more days, maybe the 6 days if you want to do them in full, that is a good sign that you are accepted. العلامات على قول الشرح الصدق للطاعة. Now you feel that you want to come to the masjid more. You're missing Ramadan. You feel the sweetness of Qiyam al-Layl, the sweetness of prayer, the sweetness of Iman, al-Ta'a, like you did in Ramadan. Maybe not on the same level, because that's the normal thing, but you feel it. You got it. You got the sense of it, and you still carry it until now. That is one of the shu'ub, halawat al-Iman, kadhaf al-alamat al-Qabul. أقول قولي هذا وأسأل الله العظيم لي ولكم التقوى والقبول والرضا والشكر اللهم آمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين العاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين الآثمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. The final point I want to conclude with, inshallah. Reminder of the points again. At-taqwa, did we gain at-taqwa or not? Let's answer this question. Did we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not for all of these things that He has given us in Ramadan? Did we ask Allah to accept and make sure He accepts our actions in Ramadan and qabool? Did He accept it or not? And finally, what are we going to do after Ramadan? Let's not waste everything that we have done in Ramadan. We have worked so hard to be muttaqun, to be, you know, amongst al-ubbad, al-zuhad, al-salihin, al-qaniteen, those who pray at night, those who fast for Allah, those who do this and that, whatever we have done in Ramadan. Let's not go in reverse, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us against wasting our hasanat by giving us this example of an old lady. She had some mental issues in Mecca, and she used to spend the entire day time in sewing some stuff and doing some, broideries and sewing and stuff, and that takes so long, all day, doing it by hand, stitch by stitch, which takes so long. And then at the end of the day, because she had some mental issues, she would undo everything. You see how easy it is to take one little thread and just pull it, and then you undo everything. You undo everything you have done. She used to do that. Work all day, تغزي يومها كله. And then at the end of the day, عند نهاية اليوم, تنظر غزلها. Allah said, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ أَنْكَافَ. To the end of the ayah. So Allah said, do not be like this lady. She used to do all this ghazl and woven and stuff all day long by hand. And then at the end of the day, نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا. She will undo all of that. So let's not waste. بعضنا يا أحباب يضيع مثلا قيام ليالي في جلسة من جلسة. One session. One little gossip session or something, that should be enough to waste 5-6 nights of Qiyam al-Layl. You come and Sheikh Amr is going so long and killing us in these salawat and mashallah, and all of that work you are getting, one session talking about XYZ and Ghaib and Amina. Actually, you had a bag full of hasanat, and then you're making a little hole, could be a big hole at the bottom, and you are losing this hasanat. We don't want to do that. You have collected hasanat from fasting, from sadaqah, from zakawat, from doing what you have done in Ramadan, don't waste it. Remember the ayah, وَلَا تَكُونُ كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ. You make effort to collect the money, you work hard and you get the money, and then you spend it left and right, and then you waste it. You wouldn't do that. You wouldn't usually do that. So let's not do that with our hasanat, with our good deeds that we have achieved, that we have gained, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's keep them and not waste them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is giving us this advice. This Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and a'inana ala al-amal as-salih ba'da Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us power and strength to continue to do good, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, wa yatuba alayka, wa yaghfir lana, wa yarhamna, wa yataqabbalna, wa yaj'alna min al-muttaqin. May Allah make us amongst those who are conscious to Him. May Allah make us from the mukhlisin, from those who are sincere to Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the abideen, the zahideen, the muttaqeen, from those who always worship Him, and they are keen to worship Him the best. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us strength and power to resist shayateen, to resist our own desires and ourselves, and make us like prophets and like companions and like righteous people who are getting close to that. Allahumma aghfir lana wa rahamna wa anta ghafur rahim. Allahumma aghfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya' minhum wal amwat. إنك يا مولانا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم أعد علينا رمضان أزمنة عديدة وأزمنة مديدة يا رب العالمين. والله give us a chance again and again to witness the good opportunity of Ramadan while being healthy, and give us قوة and power to do طاعات all the time in Ramadan and after Ramadan. اللهم آمين آمين آمين. I would like to take this chance, inshallah, to thank on behalf of the board of directors and me personally, to thank every single person who volunteered in the month of Ramadan, who made anything that we have done here in Ramadan possible. I don't want to name anything, but we really have a lot of different groups and teams who have done so great job. Is that Allah khair? And also specifically those who helped in making the day of Eid, the fun day that we had, was it yesterday? A couple of days ago, since the time is still closed. So, Jazakumullah khair, Mr. Chali, Brother Yusuf Tiffin, and everybody, Al-Talib Mahmoud, everybody who made that, Sister Azka as well, and so many other brothers and sisters. And if you start naming people, you'll definitely miss others. Jazakumullah khair, Jazakumullah khair for all the volunteers in Ramadan, and in the Eid, and keep up the new job, and we need to see more and more people who will, you know, stand up and join us and volunteer with us. Jazakumullah khair. And before I forget, also let's not forget the names, dua for Abu Hashim Mubarak's mother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as-salah and ya'fu anha wa mufakut anha, inshaAllah, she is sick and she needs your dua. Thank you.
Please check your cell phone, please, after the salah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'as-salati, hayya 'alal-falah. Qad qamat as-salatu, qad qamat as-salah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Always forget people. Now I forgot Brother Tanman. So when I saw him, he was in front of the grill. No, I have seen that. Just me coming closer to the grill, huge grill that we got back then. He is also the one who got us this, mashallah. Just getting closer to it was so cold. I mean, hot. You feel the heat. So he was there in front of the grill amongst a few other brothers, Brother Bashir and other brothers. I don't want to forget anybody. They were there for hours and hours. And everybody, and every sister and brother who helped in anything that he helped. Safim and Tasir were fed you.
Allah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Malik Yawm al-Din. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. اللهم سمع الله لمن حمده. الله الله الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. أفلا كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. سمع الله حمدا. الله الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
There was a little confusion about Salat al-Isha time. We will stick to 9:15 inshallah starting tonight because the time will start going back. So tonight inshallah we'll be praying 9:15.